Hello everyone and welcome to the quarterfinals of the Nordic Caravan Norwegian Open 2023, where we have Jonas Hegaard versus Peter Roberts. Just about to get underway. So Peter currently holding a shot. Jonas got his last bowl. Just ran through. Taken two out, just looking at the third. So just a two there. So Peter Roberts, our current Norwegian Open champion, takes a 2-0 lead against Jonas Hegaard. Shot there from Jonas, just taking a shot. Oh, unlucky there from Peter to get through that gap. Jonas playing with very straight bowls, vectors. Rex Goodyear with this one. Taking a shot there. Not quite there with that one, so Peter takes the shot. And a 3-0 lead after two ins. Solid start from Peter there. Another good ball from Peter there. Jonas coming up to have a look. That's two to Jonas. Yep, I'll get a score update on some of the other quarterfinals. Nathan Hare's 7-1 up on Ferdinand Franson. And Peter Roberts is 5-0 up after three ends against Jonas. Other quarterfinal, Craig Burgess versus Stephen Gale. Let's try and get a score update on that one. Good start from Jonas. Just trying to get on the board. Let's not let this game slip away too early. Good reply from Peter there. Thank you. Very good bowl from the owner, sir. It's made three at the moment. Pete's got them two back bowls though. Jonas has got the shot. I'm sure he'd be tempted to roll Peter's other bowl away here, just off the centre line to make three. He's rolled it away. He's not quite got it quite plumb, but he's made another shot, so that's two. So it's now 5-2 to Peter Roberts. Daniel Sands is 7-1 up in one of the other quarterfinals. Two in this one to Peter after four ends. 9-1 to Nathan Hare after four ends against Ferdinand Frentzen. It's a good start from Jonas. Give you an update on the Craig Stephen one in a minute, Mario. Just trying to work out who's home and away. Good reply from Peter now. Another good bowl from Peter. It's a very good hit from Jonas. Gets the shot back. Of his best back. Just a one at a moment that Jonas is holding. But he's got a touch of the play with. Yeah. And that one as well. That goes right onto the jack. In the match between Craig and Stephen, it is 6-5 to Craig at the moment. against Stephen Gamm. Well, that'll be a tussle. Ferdinand also pulled back. It's now 9-5 against Nathan Hare. Just fell off, it's still moving, that ball, but great effort. So that's one to Peter. It's gone out 6-2 after five ends to Peter. He's in search to try and retain his Norwegian title. That's a good start from Jonas. Just waving it on, didn't want it sitting next to it, so it could be available for a takeout. He's got another one waiting at the back there. Position quite well actually. It stops the jack going back. Jonas is a bit concerned, hands on his head, but I don't think that's finished too bad. It's awkward now for Peter to get that jack back, so still if he arrives here, the back pole is going to go, but he is three down, so needs to be careful. Back end trying to get the edge of it, chip it off the side. That's where we'll be playing here by the looks of it. Oh, what a ball! He's played it, cleared both the bowls away, ran through with a jack into the pack of his bowls. Sits three on. It's three down to three on. What a turnaround. And Jonas, I'm sure, is going to be trying to get this offside as well. That was a good solid hit, but cut it down. So that's one to Peter. 7-2 now after six. Six in a Craig Stephen Gow game. 9-7 to Nathan Hare after six ends as well. So Ferdinand coming back in that one. And Peter again with another great start. Jonas attacking it early. Just falls off, so it doesn't need a lot to get these jacks off the side. with the pace being so quick. So it's first dead end in this game. Attacking it again. Gets a jack in. Just been done that, did that a lot in a previous match against Mark Beattie. He beat on the last end. So he's going to want to be trying to shake this game up probably with those sort of tactics. Difficult to tell, he's got a shot on them angles. I think it's one to Pete with this one to the right. Jonas, no nonsense. Chips that bowl away. Against Ferdinand Frampton after seven ends in that one. So really tightened up. It was 9-1 at one stage. So that's a great bowl by Pete, that right on the line. To that bowl. He's looking to roll it out and sit. And just looking for both bowls. Yeah. Under it. Oh. Well. He's not happy with that, but that is some result. Nearly got the other bowl off the side for two. Just have a look at who's got shots. One to Jonas. He's also the Jack Long, so we know what's coming here. It's now 7-3 after seven ends. Quarterfinals of the Norwegian Open. And that is a very good start. The jacking clean, just guaranteed the one. Did a second there, just resting on that bowl. Peters. Oh, it's unlucky from Peter. Didn't quite get that ball, the bowl full. So Jonas currently holding two. Oh. again, just not quite, couldn't quite get hold of that bowl. Yeah, you just make sure of that, just to keep it to one. Now 7-4 to Pete after 8 ends. Okay, so Yunus goes again on the first bolt, just nipped underneath it. Try and ditch the jack. Pete's going around the back to try and stop that, but just overcooks it. So Yunus goes again. Again, just misses it wide. Jonas opting to switch the hands, playing the backhand positive. In, but there is quite a bit of room still. But got the shot. Nathan Hare is currently 14-8 up after 9 ends against Ferdinand Franson. One of the other quarterfinals. Stephen Gow is 9-6 up against Craig after 9 ends. Jonas certainly got the shot and is tight in the second, looks 2 to me. But Pete's got his last bowl. Yeah. Looks close. It stops. And does, and drawing the shot. Now takes a 4-shot lead, 8-4 after 9 ends. Still opting for the attacking game. Catches Peter's back bolt. So he puts it back again. Imagine if that bowl sits down, Pete will be looking to be a bit aggressive at this, but it's standing up, an awkward angle. Very good response. just fallen over as Jonas is bowled. But very good bowl. Both touches stayed on and put Peter's touch off the side. Just asking what the situation is. Looks like one to me. Hit. Peter put the jack in a ditch. And let's just come and have a look. Let's get in and have a look ourselves. It's got two touches to play with. That's a roll one of them in. Probably at least, I think, one down with a bow in a ditch. Underneath it. Two to Peter. It's now 10-4 after 10 ends. Two left. Currently 14-9 to Nathan Hare. After 10 ends against Ferdinand Franson. First semi-finalist is Daniel Sands, who's guaranteed at least the bronze medal. Stephen Gow is 10-6 up on Craig Burgess with two ends to go. Jonas just having a think about the situation because he's got to make at least two to continue the match. Jonas just come and have a look because it's going to be difficult. It's going to have to try and take out both front bowls without moving a jack. Stay for three. The J Jack moves. Peter's got these two bowls here over the back. The back left two here. Oh. And that's the match. Peter Roberts is out into the semi-finals of the Norwegian Open and beats Jonas Hegaard 11-4. So let's go over to some of the other quarter final. Between Stephen Gow and Craig Burgess. Stephen Gow is 10-7 up. Craig needs to find a way making three on his last bowl here. Sure, I've got an option for him either. So have to try and lose all three green bowls and keep his on. Suggestions in a postcard. Yeah, it's crazy asking for suggestions. I think it's going to be a loads of weight on a backhand and see what happens. But I think as soon as he hits his bowl on a centre line, it's going to go off the side. His other bowl, so even if he cleared all three, he'd only have two if his other one stayed on. And big weight. Getting the slips out down the other end. Stephen Gow thinks into the semi-finals, and stay tuned and thanks for joining, and we will be with you for the next round of matches for the semi-finals and final. Thank you very much for watching.